You've got to look after your mental well-being, because it all comes from there. You know, if you look after your emotions and your mental state, you know, the world's a great place. You know, if it's not in a good place, we're all doomed. I'm going to die. Fear's in there. Oh, Jesus, I don't like anything. I'm going to run away. And the gloom comes in, and we just get more and more depressed. And if you're working at the right stuff, like I say, if you're eating well, if you're doing a bit of exercise, you're keeping yourself, you're talking to the right people. You know, my mum always used to say, show me your friends and I'll show you you, you know. And it's a bit about the information you're getting through. You know, we say stick with the winners and win with the stickers, you know. And we need to be surrounded by people that are feeding, you know, feeding your positivity stuff, you know, and writing the information. If you're watching really bad movies, you know, on a continual basis, it's not doing your mental
or if you're watching the news, which is really bad on a continual basis at the moment, that is going to be naturally very depressing.
So you need to put it in perspective. So you need to balance this out with some information that's great and it's good for your mental well-being. You know, just this conversation I'm having to you today, you know, my therapy's done. You know, this is great stuff. We're talking about some great stuff here, you know. I've got no fears that I'm going to be able to handle this situation with the support network that I've got in place, with the emotional and mental support, including my health exercise program. I've got no doubt whatsoever that I'm going to be okay. I'm going to, on a day-to-day basis, look at my mental health, because that's what I've been doing for the last 23 years. WhatsApp and Zoom, you know, it's very important, and you mentioned it earlier, and, you know, my 73-year-old mother-in-law, I was teaching her how to try and do WhatsApp, you know, and FaceTime with her, you know, and she's just got it. And my 10-year-old, I've got one this age and one this age.
It's brilliant though, isn't it?
And my 10-year-old's going, she's got all her mates and they're all giggling like 10-year-olds. I don't know what they're talking about, but Lolly and all her friends are talking online. And then I've got my, she can't turn around and facing the other way. And I'm going, oh.
But you can see her ear because she's putting it in the wrong. Yeah,
you've got it. But we put you know, and it's great because you're not going to be able to see your grandchildren at the moment and stuff. And it's a great opportunity.
Well, it's great for their your children's mental health as much as your mother-in-law's.
I don't think we've ever been more in touch because of it. To be honest with you, we've really reached out to the elderly and to the, you know, to actually get them involved in it. And she's loving it. She's going, oh my God, yeah, this is great. You know? And then she didn't answer this morning because she wasn't ready for the call.
Fair enough.
No, she was.
Yes, no, I know what you mean. She's got to get dressed.
So she said, oh no. And I said, why didn't you get, can you not work it out? Because I checked in again. I said, have you sorted it out? Are you okay? So I practiced this morning and I rang her and she didn't answer. When I asked, she still ain't got it. Let's call her. And I called her and I said, have you got it? Is there something wrong? She said, oh no, I wasn't decent.
Standards, Tony. Standards, you know,
absolutely.
That. You play for Arsenal. Standards. Extremely
important.
I said,
okay, but you've got it now.
You've got it. This is going to be a difficult, fascinating, long, worrying time, isn't it? I think we're going to find out quite a lot about ourselves as individuals, as families, but also as a society, aren't we?
Yeah, and I think there's some really positives in there as well, as many gifts that you can have from that as well. There's a lot of stuff, like I was saying to my daughter, said, what are you going to do? You know, why don't you learn the piano? You know, why don't you go and speak Spanish or something? You know, my wife speaks Spanish. You know, why don't you set up some online courses? Why don't you study? You know, why don't you? Because, you know, I've not worked, as it in effect, for 2 years now myself. And my daughter's been laid off. So it's a time of change. But if you can look for the positives in it, and you know, otherwise you go, oh, no, and you've kind of wasted this point. We've been given an opportunity maybe to grow in other areas of our life. Yes, it's stressful. Yes, it's absolutely, I want to hug people. You know, I want to come to you today and give you a big kiss, Mark. You know what I mean? But I can't do it, mate. You know what I mean? So it's a whole part of who I am is that kind of contact. You know, I need that connection. I need that love. I want to give you love, mate, but I can't do it at the moment. So how do I do it? By coming here, talking to you and getting out there and spreading the word that there's other ways out there. Books, apps, like you say, and breathe.